Good evening. First tonight, wild weather has ravaged New South Wales with tornado-like storms tearing through Sydney and floodwaters swamping towns on the mid-north coast. Queensland's southeast is now bracing for a drenching with up to 300 millimetres of rain expected over the next 2 days. In New South Wales, the flood crisis has left more than 20,000 people isolated. SES crews have been working around the clock, responding to more than 4,600 calls for help. 1,700 of those came from Sydney alone, where winds of up to 100 kilometres an hour caused widespread damage and cut power to 8,000 homes. We have reporters right along the east coast tonight with Natasha Exelby in Sydney, Georgie Glover on the New South Wales mid-north coast and Ursula Hager in Brisbane. First, let's go to Natasha. And Tash, truly a terrifying night for many residents right across Sydney.
Indeed, Tash, it's actually still pretty windy now, as you can probably tell, but absolutely nothing like last night. To give you some idea, we're in one of Sydney's most exclusive suburbs, and underneath all of this is actually a footpath, and we're seeing destruction like this all over the city, but it is in isolated pockets. As we drove around today, we saw some streets that looked completely untouched, but then, as you're about to see, some that were right next door that were just riddled with destruction.
5 minutes of fury created a mammoth mess that'll take months to mend.
At 12:20, there was a roar like an express train, and a typhoon strength wind came up Willoughby Street.
As the head of Clean Up Australia, Ian Keenan's used to cleaning up, but not his own home, which now looks like a treehouse, and not the fun kind.
My neighbour had a beautiful eucalypt, this big, and it came crashing down over three backyards onto the roof of my garage and caused a lot of damage.
Through the night, emergency crews carried out rescues and saved stranded motorists. This was Malabar, southeast of the city. A mini tornado ripped through a street, hurling this trampoline onto a power line. The local RSL was gutted. It'll be closed for weeks.
We've lost about 25% of our roof, and the water's come through from the top floor all the way through to the club, and you can see the damage behind me where it's eventually ended up in the restaurant.
The area was cordoned off today as a hot zone. The busted RSL roof has caused an asbestos spill. The cyclonic winds whipped trees around like weeds. Another mini tornado crushed Kiama on the south coast.
So this is an entire wall of a shed which has been ripped off and flung onto the streets. And I guess that's not particularly unusual given the circumstances. But what's truly amazing is that it came about 100 metres that way from the sailing club before it ended up here.
Across Sydney and surrounding areas, hundreds of residents spent their Sunday cleaning up the rubble and patching up their homes.
Ridge cap tiles, most of them are gone. Had some holes punched in the tin parts of the roof as well.
And yet, so many count themselves lucky.
Some of the houses up the road, they haven't even got any windows anymore. The school up the road, the roller shutter doors have been torn right out of their tracks.
A lot of the victims are insured. Still, SES is getting a head start.
They were here at 4 a.m. to cut up all the trees in the street, to clear the street. Mm. And we've got a lot better view now. We see the harbour now.
But it's probably a pretty tough way of doing it, though.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Positive thoughts in a time where the weather has been anything but.
And Tash, these people are going to need all the positivity they can muster. The damage bill has been estimated to be well into the millions.
Tash, thank you. Parts of New South Wales remain underwater tonight as floodwaters tear their way through the state's mid-north coast. Residents in Kempsey have been keeping a very nervous watch on the Maclay River, which breached the town levee this morning, spilling water through the CBD. Nearby Port Macquarie has also been on flood watch, with some homes inundated. Georgie Glover is in Coffs Harbour for us tonight, where just south the state's major highway has been cut off. Georgie, understandably, it's been a very anxious 24 hours across that region.
Anxious, absolutely, Tash. And the worst part is that the floods are just so unpredictable. We currently have 4 evacuation orders in place across the mid-north coast, which is where we are. They're at Settlement Point, parts of Port Macquarie, the lower Macquarie River and at Kempsey. Now, on top of that, there are 11 evacuation warnings in place for communities also on the mid-north coast. There are three evacuation centres that have been set up to help out these people. They're at Kempsey High School, Anglican Hall at South West Rocks, as well as Port Panthers at Port Macquarie. So if you are stranded, that's the place to go. However, today it was Kempsey who copped the brunt of it.
Disappearing beneath the raging water, Kempsey is in trouble. The flood levee protecting the town has been breached, endangering families and homes. But the SES was ready for it.
Hi. We're just dropping off ground around to door-to-door knocking to let Richard know about the flood.
Altogether, more than 19,000 people were either warned or ordered to evacuate the mid-north coast and take shelter at makeshift rescue centres. Those that risked remaining behind did whatever they could to safeguard their homes and businesses. At Clybucca, flooded farmers were getting worried. Dirk managed to get his wife, kids and his cattle to safety when he had the chance. Now he's stuck, but assures us his best mate will watch his back from the balcony.
All the best, mate. Yeah, no worries.
They don't want to jinx it, but neighbours Ray and Paul think they've dodged the deluge.
A sigh of relief for you then?
Oh, my word, yes. We've been pretty lucky.
Even so, Ray has an escape plan.
Oh, just so I could have a good night's rest and just so I don't get hemmed in with the flood and cause anyone else a problem, because they've got to rescue you, otherwise you can't get out.
Flooded roads also snookered truck drivers. Dennis Turnerman was meant to be in Melbourne yesterday.
We first got stuck at Woodburn there. We were there for 12 hours. Then we come down to Nambucca and we were there for 10 to 12 hours as well. And now we've gone here to Clydebucca and we're here for a couple of days now.
We've come as far south as we can now, and you can see why. Take a look behind me. The water is rising really, really quickly, and they estimate that within a half an hour, this entire road will be flooded.
The water has receded along the Nambucca River. The clean-up is sweaty, gritty work, with debris washed in from who knows where.
You've got snakes. You've got dead carcasses coming down, especially cattle. And you get spiders, a hell of a lot of spiders and ants. I've probably had about 2 hours sleep.
And there'll be little sleep for flood victims again tonight, who never know what damage the water could do.
I think everyone will agree that we need to say a massive thank you to all our SES volunteers. 800 volunteers in total helping people out when everyone gets stuck. And already today, they've rescued an additional 14 people.
Absolutely fantastic effort by the SES. Thanks so much, Georgie.